I will say this though. I will say this though. And this is something one guy, this guy does say, is that because here's the thing. And I was watching both when I was watching SmackDown Friday night. I watched SmackDown and I watched Rampage. Okay.
Right.
At work last night, I watched them both. One thing completely noticeable, okay, is the crowd. Okay, if you look at the crowd, it's definite contrast. A lot of kids and a lot of girls, mothers in the crowd at SmackDown. No kids, no mothers. It's AEW is the smart mark wrestling product right now.
Yeah.
Okay. They're not really appealing to kids. They're cussing a lot on the show. Everybody calls each other a piece of shit, like Darby did with Sean Spears. You know, they're using foul language. They're not doing the things to draw like the fans of the WWE would draw. WWE's drowning out when the fans are cussing. They're drowning out the noise.
Oh, they censored it. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So. Right, they're censored. So it's two completely different philosophies like that, okay? The smart mark crowd is kind of the nerd culture crowd. And you can look at their crowd, and you look at some of the wrestlers, and like a lot of these guys kind of are like young indie nerd guys.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, and then that's just a fact. I mean, it's like, I'm not looking to like, who's the guy, Private Party.
Yeah.
Okay? Like the Private Party guys are supposed to be cool. Okay, look at these two guys. Like these guys look like they act like nerds. You know what I'm saying? So like that's when I see like they do draw kind of more a nerd culture crowd than the WWE does.
Right.
You know, I will agree with that. I think Conan would agree with that too.
Yeah, 1,000%. 1,000%. Yeah.
So the next one's from Kong Shower.
And tremendous.
And his Clean the Monkey is his email address.
I like that too.
So Kevin Owens and AEW is no big loss to WWE. So once again, a contract is running down. The IWC are all saying that Kevin Owens will be headed to AEW. WWE lose him and AEW has him debut. That's not a big deal. I mean, Kevin Owens fan, but in AEW, Eddie Kingston has already copied his ring gear. And then what's he going to do? Redo the best friends angle with Jericho? Well, you can't because Tony Khan, the Booker of the Year, already copied that with MJF. Obviously, you should take the biggest money offer and use WWE and AEW to negotiate the biggest money possible. But as a wrestler, as a character, I don't see Owens even making the smallest dent in AEW. Joe will say, what about matches with Punk and Omega? But that will only wrench this for people who are already watching. Plus, don't they have enough white guys already? At some point, Tony Khan, the Booker of the Year, is going to get called out over this stuff. What do you think, Disco and Conan? F wrestling otaku, you loser. F Fat F, F-U-C, I'm not going to say that. This guy doesn't like Kevin Owens. I've said this, and you know, bro, like honestly, AEW, if they would like, if they didn't have like, what's the word I want to use? If they didn't have like, what do you call it? When you have a business plan, what's it called usually? A mission statement, okay?
Yeah.
Their mission statement is like they weren't going to be WWE. You know, they're going to be alternatives or everything. But I think what we're seeing with Cole and Daniel Bryan's additions this week, all right, is that in this small market, the wrestling's got basically a market of like 2.2 to 2.3 million fans to choose from. That's the most people that are watching SmackDown or whatever. You can pull, okay, because they're doing like on an average like about a million, between 900,000 and 1.1 million is their average. They got a bump for Pump that went immediately right back down, kind of like to market correction. They got a bigger bump when Daniel Bryan and Adam Cole debuted. I think that there is a market of the AEW fans that hate watch Raw, but just watch wrestling on Monday night, just watch wrestling on Friday night, and don't watch AEW, that you might be able to pull 10 to 20% of those fans if you take enough of the WWE guys, the over guys, and bring them on your show and put them there. Like, perfect example, they pulled the guys from 2.0 and put them on the show every week, and they were from NXT.
Bro, that's one of my philosophies. That, what you just said, is one of my philosophies with AAA. One of the reasons I've taken so much of the CMLL talent, because now they have no choice but to come to our shows. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's a market. Bro, it's common sense. It's like if you're trying to draw fans, and like I guess there's the same thing right now going on between AEW fan base and WWE fan base that's going on in Mexico with the AAA fan base and CML fan base. Like, they don't watch, like,
right.
Both groups of fans don't watch Mega all heat. The shows. Right. Right. Yeah, it's right. Okay. So we have that now. You can pull some of the fans from WWE if you sign Braun, if you sign The Fiend.
Yeah, yeah.
It may cost you money and everything, but, bro, but if you sign want Owens, that market,
sign Zayn, yeah.
You're not going to pull WWE fans putting Hook, Hobbs and Private Party on your show. Right. You don't know, so that you're not going to draw
about
the WWE fans.
Abaddon.
You're not going to, like I said, if they want to do it, you can do it, bro. They could pass Raw in 2 months. If they get Braun everything and featured those guys every week to where the people that watch Raw every week are like, well, I'm gonna watch on Monday now. I'll just watch on Wednesday and Friday. I'll watch these guys like they're doing more stuff with Daniel Bryan and
Bro,
and
just Cole think and Braun about, than they did just WWE, think about you know? This. Here's a company who's only been around for 2 years and making mistakes because they're experimenting. They're still, you know, when I look at a lot of times at Tony, he reminds me of me when I first started booking, you know. Mm-hmm. So he overproduces stuff. You know, he's still learning, bro. It's not easy. If not, anybody could do it. But
right. They've
got to be worried about a that's only been in the business for 2 years, already on their doorstep pulling a 1.4, mm-hmm. you know.
And you're letting buy your talent.
Yeah. Right.
You know, and like sometimes you
let him figure this shit out and you're really going to be in trouble.
Yeah. And the thing about Owens is, I'm not going to say, oh, dream matches and all, but if you sign Owens, if he goes to AEW, he's got to be at least in their top five, you know, guys on the mic, maybe even top three. So I think
this is one thing you've definitely noticed.
Yeah.
Okay. Adding Daniel Bryan, CM Punk, and Adam Cole significantly increased the quality of the promos on their show. Significantly. You know, the WWE system, these guys are just better talkers than the indie guys. And they are, you know, not like MJF and stuff, but like, you know, Kevin, all these guys cut a better promo than Lance Archer. I like Lance Archer and everything, but he's not a promo like Adam Cole and these guys. You know, Brian Cage doesn't cut promos like these guys. There's so many guys on that show that might get passed over because these guys are stronger on the mic than them. But Kevin Owens is stronger on the mic. You know what I'm saying? So he would have a spot. I would disagree with this guy because Kevin Owens is strong on the mic.
And he can go in the ring, bro. Yeah. Still great in the ring, yeah.
Yeah.